Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about Apple's new Fusion Drive. So you now have three options when buying a new Mac Mini or a new iMac. You've got your standard hard drive, you have your SSD, your solid state drive, which is flash memory as a hard drive, and you have something called a Fusion Drive, which was just introduced. So what exactly is a Fusion Drive, and what advantages does it have over the other two? So the advantage of a standard hard drive is it's cheap. You can get a lot of storage for a pretty low price. Disadvantage is it's an actual disk that spins, which means it's slower, and it also uses more power. So using it in things like laptops will actually run the battery down a bit more. So solid state drives, on the other hand, use flash memory, the same things you get when you get those little thumb drives that you plug into your USB port, except that, of course, flash drives that are being used as hard drives are much larger, usually 128 gigs, maybe 256, or even some that are 512 gigs. Now the advantage of these is they're much faster. There's not a moving hard disk, it's just accessing memory, so it's faster than a standard drive, and also it uses a lot less power because of that. Disadvantage is price. It's much more expensive. They top out at half a terabyte, and those cost about $400. So you can imagine if you wanted to get a 1 terabyte or even like a 3 terabyte SSD drive, they don't even exist, and if they did, it would cost a fortune to put a drive like that into your machine. So now let's take a look at Apple's Fusion Drive. So Apple's Fusion Drive is actually two drives. You've got both in your Mac. You've got a solid state drive and you have a regular hard drive. And the software in your Mac, software in Mountain Lion, is going to combine those and treat those as a single volume. Now you may have heard of hybrid drives before. Hybrid drives are when you have one unit that's a hard drive but also has some flash memory in it. Now when you have a drive like this, basically the hard drive is your entire drive. It's all your files. And the flash memory is used as a cache. So when you access a file, it's also transferred to the cache for faster access next time. And then it's written back to the hard drive when the drive has time to do so. Kind of like a browser cache accessing files on the internet. So it's not really increasing your space, and it's kind of moving files between the cache and the hard drive, with the hard drive containing everything you have and the cache flash drive containing the files you're using at the moment or the ones you're using the most frequently, so you can quickly access them. Now Apple's Fusion Drive doesn't work like that. What it does is it combines the flash memory and the hard drive to make one disk. So the files aren't duplicated. They're not all on the hard drive and then cached on the flash drive. They are either on the flash side or the hard drive side, not both. And what Apple software does is make sure that the files you access most often are on the fast flash side of the drive, and the ones that you access only occasionally are on the slower hard drive. So at the beginning, say you might start off with your entire operating system and all the apps on the flash side, but then maybe as you use your Mac, maybe you install other applications, maybe you access files a lot, do a lot of different work. I mean, one person may be a video editor, another person may be editing images, another person may be doing a lot of web surfing. It's going to move files between the two drives so that the ones you access the most are on the fast side and the ones you access the least are on the slower side. Now it's important to note that you don't need to do anything for this to happen. It all happens seamlessly in the background. You can treat it as just one hard drive that just happens to run a lot faster than a standard hard drive and almost as fast as an SSD. Now it's very important to know that the Fusion Drive is a combination of hardware and software. You've got the hardware side, the flash memory and the hard disk, and you have the software side, which is the way that the files are managed, and that's in Mountain Lion, in the latest version of Mountain Lion that will come out with these new Macs. So you can't just get a Fusion Drive and put it into an old Mac because it's not a single unit, it's part of the machine. In addition, you can't actually use a Fusion Drive with an older version of Mac OS X. You have to have this latest version because it has the software support for it. Matter of fact, you can use a Mac that has a Fusion Drive in target disk mode as long as the computer accessing it has the latest version of Mountain Lion to be able to handle Fusion Drives. Likewise, doing things that we've taken for granted before, like partitioning the drive, doesn't work quite the same. Apple has set it up so that you can partition the drive once, and when it does it, it actually creates a partition on the hard disk. So you end up with one partition of the hard disk being part of the Fusion Drive along with the flash memory, and the second partition that you've created actually being a standalone partition. And I believe they've done this so that you could still use Bootcamp, with Bootcamp being a second partition on the drive. And if you're not using Bootcamp to run Windows, then you could always use Disk Utility, and you have to use a new version of Disk Utility too to be able to handle the Fusion Drive. And you can use Disk Utility to create the second partition. But of course, for most Mac users, you don't need to create a second partition. That's an old way of thinking of dividing up your files. Today, especially with something like the Fusion Drive, it's better just to have one partition and store your files in a logical manner in folders. So check out Apple's page with questions and answers about the Fusion Drive. I have a feeling that more will be added to this page as more questions are asked, and also as the Fusion Drive is deployed in actual Macs, like just now in the Mac Mini, but we won't have it in the new iMacs until they're released, some in November and some in December. So if you're looking for both speed and quantity in a hard drive, then the Fusion Drive on a new Mac is perfect for you. It's definitely something I'll be getting on the next Mac that I buy. I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.